Beginner's Guide to Symmetry for Kaleido Paint by Matthew. Reflection is used in Kaleido Paint in most of the formats. Now I'm going to reflect this arrow here. I just reflected that arrow, and now I'm going to reflect the star. And I have to turn the star around so that a point is pointing down, because reflection is kind of like opposites. And now I'm going to reflect this arrow in five ways. And so first it's going to go like that. Next it's going to go like that. And then like that. And then like that. And now I have reflected the arrow. And here's an example that I did on Kaleido Paint of a reflection, and there's the mirror line and the blue thing. Translation is also quite often used in Kaleido Paint. Here is how transition works. Transition is moving an object from one place to another. So I'm going to move this circle to up a bit, and I might move this square down, and I might move this rectangle along here and move the arrow up here or something. And like here's an example I did on Kaleido Paint, and I'm going to move this pattern over to here, and there it matches up, so that's like transition because it's moving that to there. And there's heaps more of other ways of doing it. Rotation is also used in Kaleido Paint. Rotation is used by going around an origin and rotating around it like that. So I just rotated that shape 45 degrees. And I'm going to rotate this rectangle 180. So there's 180. And I'm going to rotate this eclipse 45 degrees. So now I've rotated about 45 degrees, and sometimes the origin can be in different places, like in this example it's in the corner, so I want to rotate this 45 degrees, and that corner has to stay there. Like that. And with this circle it's the same thing, but the origin point has to stay in the centre of the eclipse. So I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees, and it's still in the centre of the eclipse. And here's an example I did on Kaleido Paint. And see, so you can rotate it, and it looks exactly the same.